This is Charlie for Topic, and in this video we're going to be looking at the new Nikon 24-70mm f2.8e VR lens. What's our first impressions of this lens? Well, it's big, it's heavy, it's plastic, and it's freaking expensive. Now let's talk about size of this lens. This lens measures in just over 15 centimeters, which is actually quite a lot, considering that the previous version of this lens was just over 13 centimeters. And now this is one place where you definitely don't want or need extra centimeters, is on the length of a lens, because that extra 2 centimeters is actually a pain. At the rental shop, we're already experiencing that issue, because now this new lens does not fit in some of the older cases we used to use, and it's just longer and gets in the way. Now the diameter of the lens has also been changed. The previous version used to be 77mm. This one is now 82mm. So there you go, you have to go and buy new filters now if you get this lens, and you can't easily swap between filters anymore between this lens, your 16-35 f4, and the 70-200 f2.8. Now what about weight? This lens is heavy. It clocks in at over 1 kilogram, which is quite a lot. I mean, carry this thing around for a day around your neck and you're definitely going to feel it. Now the one thing I'm the least impressed with is that the whole construction of this lens, barrel and all, is now plastic. Plastic all over. So it feels cheapish in the hand, and to be honest, I don't know if it's going to last. Because with the previous version, the normal 2.8G version, we've had lots of issues at the rental shop, and we've ended up sending almost each and every copy that we owned back for repairs at one or other stage. The reason for that is it feels that it was really sensitive to any form of a knock on front of the lens barrel. It would basically just push it a little bit out of alignment, causing major issues with the zoom mechanism. So I don't know if this plastic is going to work. Guess it's going to have to stand the test of time. So let's look at the price. This lens is $600 to $700 more than the previous version. So the big question is it worth it performance-wise? You'd expect such a massive jump in price would be justified by a massive leap forward in performance. Well, unfortunately, the performance seems very similar to the model this one is replacing. Sharpness is apparently a little bit more. The bokeh is not much better, but it's a little bit of an improvement on the previous one. Basically, they're very similar in performance. So I don't know if adding VR, adding weight, adding length justifies this massive price jump. Now let's look at the two major differences between this lens and the one that it's replacing. First, this lens has VR, or vibration reduction, basically lens stabilization. We'll look at that a little bit later in the video. And then the other big difference is that this is now a f2.8e lens. So what does that little E mean? Well, it stands for electromagnetic diaphragm mechanism. In short, a full-on electronic mechanism controlling the aperture. Whereas all the previous versions, like the G lenses, still had a mechanical mechanism physically opening up and closing up the blades. Now this difference becomes more apparent when we actually look at the rear lens mount. So this is the new 24-70E. And you see, immediately see that it's missing the little lever that we have on the G versions that controls the aperture. See there, that little lever opens and closes the aperture. And that's what's missing on the new E versions. Now, according to Nikon, this will give you a more accurate setting during filming and is apparently better. One big drawback of this new design is that this new lens now won't work on any Nikon cameras older than 2007. Or at least it will sort of work, but you'll be stuck with f2.8 and you won't be able to change the aperture. I've noticed one massive drawback of this new fancy electronic aperture. On the D750, the D810 and upwards, you can assign the function button and the preview button in front of the camera to open and close the aperture while filming video. It's called the Power Aperture feature. Now, to activate this really handy feature, what you need to do is go into the menus, make sure you navigate to the little pencil or the custom settings menu. In there, navigate all the way down to movie, and under movie, we have to set up this first function, assign FN button, and the second one, assign preview button. You just click on OK to go in there, navigate sideways, and in here, you can set up different functions. You just choose the top one, power aperture open, and just make sure that the preview button is on, power aperture close. And there you go. You can exit the menu and give it a test. Now, if this 24-70mm 2.8E lens on there, if I change the aperture, you can hear that. It is quite annoying. To show you the difference, I'm just going to quickly put a G lens on there. Now, for this exact same setup, just using the Nikon 60mm 2.8G ED lens, and also the power aperture feature, you can see that it's opening up and closing down, but you can barely hear the aperture. So that's going to be a major issue with this lens and this new aperture design if Nikon sticks to it and changes all their lenses over to it. Now let's have a look at the VR function on this lens. Now Nikon gives it the impressive rating of +4 f-stops. Now if we test it with stills, we can see that you can easily get nice and steady shots handheld at 1/15th of a second using focal length of 70mm. It works equally well with video. So you can see here with this wide shot with VR off, wide with VR on, tele with VR off, tele with VR on. So we can basically let the footage speak for itself. So at the end of the day, we have to ask, is this lens worth it, especially considering the massive price jump? But it seems in any case that all the lens is going to get discontinued, and already in New Zealand it's really difficult to get hold of the previous version of this, the non-VR model. So my suggestion would be, if you don't own a 24-70 2.8 Nikon lens yet, maybe run out and go grab the old version. They're selling them out quite cheaply at the moment. You can pick up a real nice bargain.